So let's take a look at a result. This comes from this nice little database that was published based upon this PAMI paper. Comminacci was one of the original developers of mean shift as applied to computer vision. And what you can see here, so here's our original image, all right, and then you apply mean shift, and it does a really fine job, all right? I mean, take a look at this brick structure here, and you see all of those pixels are put in the same region. Likewise, you get this front of this building here. The whole sidewalk is on one cluster with the exception of over this area, right? Well, that's in a dark shadow from the tree. You'll notice the whole shadow has been put into one cluster because the system can't, at this point, know that it's a shadow, all right? But I think you would agree that if you take a look at this picture here and you were to draw boundaries around where the different clusters were, okay, you would probably end up with an image that looked something like that. Here's some more examples of mean shift segmentation result. And you can see it does a pretty good job. You know, take a look at this picture down here. All the water is put into one cluster there. This foliage is broken out nicely, the islands, etc. So if you've got the right feature space, it does a pretty good job of finding the clusters. Finally, I want to show you an example that also comes from that same original database. And again, it has a nice original image here of the mountain. And on the right-hand side are the segmentation results. So the good news is you can see it does a pretty reasonable job. I mean, it pulls out this section, all the section up here that didn't have the snow on it, and maybe this section here as well. But notice all the texture that's going on in here. Okay. Well, it's not that that's wrong. It's just less clear that it's right. What I mean by that is it's not totally clear what you're trying to do with this picture that you're carving it up into segments. That was the original idea behind the super pixels. The idea was, let me carve this thing up into little atomic units that I know don't have to be broken up again, but whether I would combine them or use them together in some way depends upon the future processing that you have to do. So often what you'll do is a segmentation step to create these broken up these regions and then figure out how to process those regions going forward. So the segmentation then in some sense is a pre-processing step to give you a much smaller set of units to work with.